a century, the McCarthys of Cappamore in County Limerick have had an intimate link with travelling circuses. With the distinctive culture and traditions of the Big Top in Limerick and the unique artists and families that have kept this culture alive over the centuries, through good times and bad.
It was a great tradition for the circuses when they came to Cappamore that the children got very much involved with the visiting circus. They came to the village, they would have walked miles out the road to meet the circus arriving. When the circus came to Cappamore, the locals would judge the quality of the show, first of all by the number of horses that travelled with the circus. And the big John Duffy and Sons circus, they would have travelled up in the region of 100 horses. I think the success for the circuses in Cappamore was a huge hinterland. You had people that would have travelled from Maru and Doon and Rare Cross and, you know, and Boher as well. So it wasn't just the village, you know, in Cappamore. They came in from the surrounding areas as well. The late Teddy Fawcett always said that their business-wise, their two best towns was Cappamore and Killarney. And, you know, and all the shows did very well in Cappamore. The clowns, then there's some wonderful photographs he has of Johnny Quinn, a circus clown with Hannaford Circus, done up in makeup, and the costumes there, they would have been very colourful, and especially for the circus parade and the performances as well. It was glamour and glitz, it was. And the whole village really bought into this whole experience, we'll say, of the circus coming to town.
The McCarthy connection with the circus can be traced back to William McCarthy, a local publican in the village of Cappamore.
Buff Bills, of Buff Bills circus fame, when he died, there was in the World's Fair, it was published his obituary, and there was an expression of sympathy from William McCarthy in Cappamore. Yeah, so that goes back to the 1930s. So that shows the link that William McCarthy had with the visiting circuses. And he was very friendly with the visiting circuses as well.
William's interest in the visiting circuses had a great influence on his six sons, William, James, Joseph, John, Patrick and Michael, and also his daughter, Eily.
It was in their back garden, it was. You know, I mean, when they woke up in the morning, you'd have the tentmen working on the tent. And as I said, you'd have the elephants, the horses, you know, it was just a magical experience. And then they were treated to the circus parade at 1 o'clock. The circus parade would have left William McCarthy's field, and both sides of the street would have been lined with people. 1 o'clock, weather permitting, the parade would have gone out. And basically, you would have had the horses with their plumes being marched up the village, and the elephants, and you'd have clowns and jugglers, and you know, it was a wonderful spectacle. When the circus came to town, it was a festival, it was a day off. Was farmers, 12 o'clock, the Angelus bell. When the Angelus bell went in the village, farmers down tools and straight into the village. And they would have been lining the streets then, waiting for the circus parade to leave William McCarthy's circus field at 1 o'clock. You had the two performances, the matinee and the night show. And you had the artists coming in to William's pub, and they would have been doing tricks, a little jugglers or whatever, or magic, or whatever was going on. And so, you know, it was truly a magical experience, yeah, and, you know, for the whole village as well. And it was a social history of a village and its people.
The beginnings of the McCarthy Circus Bar came about in 1917 when William set his son John McCarthy up in business with another pub at the opposite end of the village.
William's son John McCarthy was my grandfather, and he would have been one of the kids there that would have been out on the street to see the circus arrive. And I suppose, you know, he had that added experience of the circus in the backfield at their own place, their own pub, and something triggered there, an interest and a fascination and a passion which developed in later years for the circus, we'll say, and as a circus enthusiast.
Over the years, as the circuses came and went, John began collecting posters and memorabilia of the different circus troupes that visited Cappamore. Many travelling groups would leave props and materials in storage with John to be collected on the next visit.
The circus memorabilia that he had been collecting since maybe 14, 13 years of age, he started displaying this wonderful circus material in the pub. And amongst the show people, it became known as McCarthy's Circus Bar. So he didn't realise it, but he was actually archiving for future generations the development of the circus arts here in Ireland.
A great day in Cappamore. Sir, it is now over 70 years ago since Transfield Circus and Cooney's Star of Erin Circus visited Cappamore on the same day, Easter Monday, 1894. This was their first opening day for that season. Both circuses stood at the top end of the village, in fields right opposite each other. Transfield's in Rainett's Field, now Blackwell's, and Cooney's in Pagham's Field, where the convent and school now stand. Both parades went out at 1 o'clock, Teddy Cooney riding his big bay horse, Stargazer, in front of his parade, going down the main street, and his band playing Gary Owen.
John McCarthy in the 1930s, he was writing these wonderful letters, getting them published, and he brought it to another level in the 1940s. He started taking photographs of the circuses arriving to Cappamore, the build-up of the circus in Cappamore, and also the wonderful circus parade in Cappamore. But he didn't realise that through his collection of photographs and memorabilia and posters and, we'd say, newsprint he was collecting and photographs, he was actually chronicling a development of the Irish circus arts here in Ireland. And his own kids, we'll say, he took wonderful photographs at the back of the pub with his kids having fun, performing on horseback, reenacting the circus routine. One item of interest that was given to my grandfather is an old eye lamp dated 1904 from Hannaford Circus. And this would have been a lamp that would have been used to light, a paraffin lamp would have been used to light up the circus ring. There's a lovely brass plate in it on the lamp.
This was a time in Ireland when circus was at the peak of its popularity, and many of the different troupes visited Cappamore and McCarthy's Circus Bar.
The golden era, we had Edward Fawcett and Sons Circus, three of the Duffy families had circuses travelling. We had John Duffy and Sons Circus, we had James Duffy and Sons Circus, we had Duffy and McLean's, Harry Linton's Circus, Kay's Brothers Circus, Rako Brothers Circus, you had Transfield Circus, Cooney's Circus, Davies Circus. Down through the years, Cappamore would have seen visiting circuses that would have been touring Ireland, that would have come over from England. Rako Brothers Circus was a big circus. They came to Cappamore. It was a big, big, big occasion to see a big show coming in like Rako Brothers. And also you had Buff Bill Circus as well. They travelled Ireland for a few years, and they would have been regular visitors to Cappamore. You know, the first sign of the circus coming to town was the bill poster, the advance man who arrived into the town. And he would have displayed these wonderful, colourful posters, we'll say. The John McCarthy Circus Archive, there's over 400 posters there in the archive. Wonderful colours and great headlines, you know, watch and wait, look and wonder, you know. The biggest circus and 25 star acts to be seen and only to be seen in this show. Each poster actually listed the acts, and it was a nice amount of reading, and it was very, you know, it gave a full insight into what the public could expect during the performances. In the era before television, the country villages like Cappamore, it must have been an amazing sight to see elephants arrive into the village. You know, the people would never have seen anything like this, and wild animals. And also, you know, with regards to different peoples coming into a country village, you would have seen Oriental people performing, you know, Chinese artists performing in the circus. One season in particular, the John Duffy and Sons circus visiting Cappamore, they advertised Indians as being part of the programme. And underneath, there's a very nice, there's a heading there that local publicans are advised not to serve the Indians spirituous liqueurs. The magic of the big top inside, you know, the sawdust ring, and, you know, there were some tremendous acts there that very, very unusual acts to be seen, you know, that you wouldn't see today, we'll say. It was the heyday for circus back then. That you had a tightrope walker that would have walked blindfolded over a den of lions. Of course, my grandfather then totally intrigued in all this as well, because he was a circus enthusiast. He had a great love and passion for the circus. He created a collage of photographs, and these would have been displayed in groups on the walls in the pub. It was very much a circus venue, as the old show people, it was known as McCarthy's Circus Bar. For the locals, it must have been intriguing as well, because the photographs and the posters were changing throughout the year. So there was a different exhibition, throughout the year to coincide with the different shows that actually visited the village.
In 1966, after the death of John McCarthy, his daughter Margaret had decided that the entire collection should be disposed of, but just as it was about to be burnt in the haggard behind the pub, John's son Paddy saved the day and brought the entire collection to Limerick, where he was living at the time. The collection then passed to his son Tony, who has now transformed the whole experience into a travelling public exhibition.
Posters we're looking at, there's roughly 400 posters, and he was very meticulous. Each poster, once it was finished, it was folded neatly and placed in a box. Also the photographs, he was taking photographs himself, I suppose because of his connection and friendship with a lot of the artists and the proprietors. They would have been sending him photographs as well, and it tells a complete history. It's a history of the development of the Irish circus from, 1900 up to 1966, when he passed away. He passed away on the 5th of February, 1966. The day I was born, and I suppose that's where it continued from there then. I developed an interest in the circuses as well, and that's the hobby. The highlights for me would be the photographs that John McCarthy himself took in the 1930s and 40s, and that shows the village scene, we'll say, and that captures the social history of the village and its people. And that's magical, because, it's an era that's long gone, and only for the likes of, John McCarthy and his circus archive, all this material and wonderful stories would have been lost.
Tony now carries on the legacy of his father Paddy, his grandfather John, and his great-grandfather William McCarthy. His love of the circus goes back to his youth and where he grew up in Limerick City.
Well, I suppose as a child, it would have been a case of I would have never have missed the circus coming to the Fair Green, passing our home in the morning with the wagons passing. And then I would have been treated to the live performance as well, going to the Fair Green. And, we would have had the visits of the Teddy Fawcett would have been a regular visit, and Tom Duffy, regular visit to our home. And I suppose I'd have a huge admiration there for the traditional show people, the people down through the years, through tough times in the 1930s and 40s with horse-drawn wagons, pulling in and out of wet fields, and you know, the hardship involved in putting on the circus with the canvas tent. And you know, these are the people that have very much kept alive the circus arts, the traditional circus arts in the country. I have huge admiration for these people, and also today the show people as well, the circus people that are keeping the traditional circus arts alive in this country. With regards to our cultural heritage, I think the John McCarthy Circus Archive is very much up there in relation to the performing arts, circus arts in this country. You know, he developed an interest, became an enthusiast, developed a passion and a love for the traditional circuses in this country. And I think that is very much seen and is very much shown in the John McCarthy Circus Archive to this day. And, you know, I'm a curator of this wonderful circus archive. And, you know, I'm living the dream now in bringing this wonderful archive in the form of an exhibition back to where this wonderful story began, and that's Capamore. Capamore.